An 83-year-old man comes in with only right shoulder pain for 3 days, and this is his ECG. Which artery is blocked? Right coronary, circumflex, or LAD? Stop and write your guess in comments. There is marked ST elevation in the second, the third, and AVF leads, pointing to an inferior wall myocardial infarction. Notice also the pathological Q waves in the inferior leads. They appear as permanent mark of necrosis. The negative T waves are part of dynamic evolution of MI, typically appearing after 1-3 days after injury. Lead AVL shows ST depression, the reciprocal change. In the chest leads, ST elevation from V4 to V6 suggests anteroapical and anterolateral wall involvement, with reciprocal ST depression in V1, V2. Angiography confirmed right coronary artery clot at the bifurcation of the posterior lateral and left ventricular branches at the crux, explaining both the inferior wall and changes in V4, V6. Remember, acute coronary syndrome doesn't always mean chest pain. It can present as shoulder pain, excessive sweating, indigestion, dizziness, or shortness of breath, especially in women. So would you have guessed the right coronary artery clot from just a shoulder pain? Follow for more ECG challenges.